Gravitational waves are ripples in space-time geometry, and they're predicted by Einstein's theory of general relativity. And we actually already have pretty good evidence that gravitational waves do exist, but we've never seen them directly. And so this announcement may be the first evidence of a real direct observation of gravitational waves. In this case, the gravitational waves are thought to be produced by the merger of two very large black holes into an even larger black hole. And this provides us with a test of Einstein's theory of general relativity that is in an area that we've never been able to test it before. We have other tests of relativity. For example, all GPS devices include corrections that are based on general relativity, and that's the only reason they work. So we're pretty sure that the theory is right at some level. But these merging black holes are a very extreme regime where we can test the theory and we can find out it's right. This experiment, the LIGO experiment, they use a laser beam that bounces back and forth between mirrors. The mirrors are 4 kilometers, or about 2.5 miles apart. And the total distance between the mirrors wiggles by less than 1/1000th of the nucleus of an atom. So it's a very tiny effect, and it's an amazing fact that they've been able to produce methods that can detect such a small variation. It also opens up the possibility of actually doing, instead of astronomy with light, doing astronomy with observing gravitational waves. So it's an exciting new possibility of doing a new kind of astronomy.